A glacier is a moving river of ice on land. There are two types of glacier. Continental glaciers are massive amounts of ice that cover continents such as Antarctica or Greenland. 95% of ice on Earth is locked up in continental glaciers. Alpine glaciers are formed in mountainous regions. Most of New Zealand's largest glaciers are in the Southern Alps, which have the highest mountains and the heaviest precipitation. Glaciers originate from heavy snowfalls over a long period of time. When snow initially falls, it has many air spaces between the snowflakes. Over time, the weight of new snow above it squeezes the air out of the pore spaces and compacts the snow, just like me making the snowball. Eventually, this compaction causes the snow to become ice. Because the air is being squeezed out, the ice will turn a bluish colour. Glaciers have several components. The area where the snow falls is usually the part of the glacier with the highest elevation and is called the zone of accumulation. Further down the glacier is the zone of ablation, where most of the melting and evaporation occurs. Here, the ice shows a lot of crevasses. The end of the glacier is called the terminus, or snout. At many glaciers, there are glacial lakes at the terminus. A glacier will continue to grow as long as the rate of ice formation in the zone of accumulation is greater than the rate of ice melting in the zone of ablation. When more melting takes place than ice forming, the glacier is said to be in retreat. The Tasman glacier, for example, has been in retreat, causing the Tasman lake to grow increasingly larger. In 1973, this lake did not exist. Over a single year, a glacier may both grow and retreat, depending on the rate of accumulation compared to the rate of ablation. This is called the glacial budget.
In times when global climate has been cooler, glaciers have expanded. We call these periods glaciations. Warmer periods have seen glaciers in retreat, and we call these inter-glacials. Now, at this time in history, glaciers are in retreat. Where I'm standing here at the Franz Josef Glacier was actually once hundreds of meters under ice. You can see behind me this pool, which is known as Peter's Pool. It is what we call a kettle pool. And what it is formed when a glacier that is in retreat leaves behind a huge like iceberg, and eventually that iceberg melts and forms this pool.
The tremendous weight of the ice combines with gravity to cause the glacier to move. At locations where a glacier flows rapidly, cracks called crevasses form. Crevasses are very dangerous to climbers and should be avoided. The terminus of a glacier is also very dangerous.